गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट 13th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स। So what are 13th group elements? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. These are called 13th group elements. Okay. So boron having different behavior when comparing with remaining elements in 13th group elements. So that different behavior here we called anomalous. Anomalous behavior, or abnormal behavior of boron. This is today's topic. Anomalous behavior or abnormal behavior of boron when comparing with remaining elements in 13th group elements. Let's see the what are the difference and that anomalous behavior of boron from other elements. Okay, so right in that first point, so very easy, already we discussed about these all points, but specially here also we discussed in anomalous behavior. Okay, so you know very well, Boron belongs to 13th group, am I right? Boron is the smallest one among 13th group elements. 13th group elements, its atomic radii is very small compared with other 13th group elements, that means radius. When radius is small, size also small, so smallest atom. Okay. Boron is a non-metal, and also we consider this is a semi-metal. Already we discussed about this semi-metal, or also we call it is metalloid. Ionization energy, I.E means ionization energy. Ionization energy or ionization potential, both are same. Ionization enthalpy also we call it is, both are same. Already we discussed about this concept, once see the previous topic. Ionization energy, ionization potential of boron is very high. That means sum of first three ionization energy of boron is very high. First three ionization means ionization 1, ionization energy 2, plus ionization energy 3. Sum of the first three ionization energies very very high. Okay, so due to high ionization energy of boron, it is unwilling to lose electrons readily. Okay, boron shows plus 3 oxidation state. Maximum oxidation state of boron is +3. Okay, but remaining elements of 13th group or third also we call it is 13th group shows +1 and also they try to exhibit +3 also. Okay, +3 also, remember this. Maximum covalency of boron is 4. That means it can able to form 4 bonds around it. Covalency means number of covalent bonds possible. Okay, covalency, so number of bonds around it may be chance 4 bonds. Okay, but covalency of other 13th group elements is 6. That means they can able to form 6 bond around it remaining. Remember this. Okay, so here, so some difference is there between boron and remaining elements in 13th group elements. Okay, except boron, remaining elements in 13th group called as metals. Okay, is it clear? Except boron, remaining elements in 13th group called as metals. Okay, am I clear? So boron is a non-metal, remaining all are metal. Okay, boron cannot show inert pair effect. Already discussed about this inert pair effect. That inert pair effect means inert pair effect. The remaining are shows, especially thallium indium can shows the inert pair effect. So inert pair effect means NS electrons not involved in chemical bonds with other atoms. So not willing, NS electrons of 13th group elements except boron not willing to participate in the chemical bond. That is called as inert pair effect. These all are involved in inert pair effect, but boron does not participate, follow the inert pair effect. That means what is the electronic configuration of boron? Its atomic number is 5. That means it has 5 electrons. Now write the electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, am I right? So these are the outermost electronic configuration. These electrons can able to participate in the chemical bond. So it does not follow the net pair effect. What is the net pair effect? These NS electrons not involved in the chemical bond. So that is the net pair effect. Boron cannot follow that net pair effect. That means these NS electrons participate in the chemical bond. Okay? So remember this. Net pair means NS pair of electrons not participate. The electrons which are present in NS, that means in the valence shell, the electrons which are in S orbital cannot able to participate in the chemical reaction. They are chemically inert, that means unwilling to participate in the chemical reaction. Okay, that phenomena is called as net pair effect. But in the case of boron, these electrons participate in chemical reaction. So boron cannot follow the net pair effect. Is it clear, student? Up to? Okay. So there is special behavior of boron. Okay, special behavior of boron is called as anomalous behavior or abnormal behavior when comparing with remaining elements in 13th group elements. So that is the today's topic. Okay. Next, boron does not give cation in aqueous solutions. Aqueous means in presence of water. In presence of water, when boron dissolved in water, it does not give aqueous. That means does not give cations. That means cations means when boron loses the electrons, it becomes as cation. But boron unable to lose the electron easily. Why? Because that means boron unwilling to lose 3 electrons due to high ionization energy. That means sum of first 3 ionization energy is very high for boron. Okay, due to high ionization energy of boron. That means boron B plus 3, that 3 electron, here it loses 3 electrons and it B plus 3 means here it is cation or not cation. Okay, so less tendency, this type of cation formation is less tendency, not easily give 3 electrons. Okay, why? Because due to high ionization energy. Due to high ionization energy, we can unable to remove the electrons from the boron. It is very difficult. We need to offer more energy to remove the electrons from the boron. Okay, is it clear? So B plus 3 cation in aqueous medium not easily formed. We apply more energy. That is the meaning of this point. So boron does not give cation in aqueous solution. That is boron unwilling to lose 3 electrons due to high ionization energy. So removing of electron by using energy is called as ionization energy here. Why? Because boron has small size, you know. If you want to remove the electron from their outermost shell, okay, that electron is very close to the nucleus. That attaches are very very strong to the nucleus and outermost electrons. So we need to apply more energy. So it is difficult to remove the electron. That is the meaning of that point. Okay. So boron does not give cations in aqueous solution. That is boron unwilling to lose 3 electrons. If it is lose electron, it becomes cation. Okay. So this tendency is very less. Formation of cation tendency is very very less. Okay. Remember this point. Okay. Boron does not decompose in water or steam but other 13th group elements undergoes decompose means breakdown, okay, decompose in hot water or steam, that means vapor. Okay, other elements undergoes decomposition, but boron does not undergoes decomposition in water or steam. Okay, boron halides are monomeric halides. Boron halides means BX3, where X is equals fluorine, chlorine, bromine, or iodine. For example, boron trichloride, boron tribromide, and boron triiodide. These are all boron halides. Okay? These are exist as monomeric hydrides, monomeric halides. These are called as halogens. Already we discussed this topic also. Oh, halides, boron trifluoride exist as BF3 only. BCl3 exist as BCl3, BBr3, okay, BI3. So BF3 is called as monomeric halide, means it is just as BF3 only. So not two more BF3 molecule combined. Okay, so now monomeric only. Let's see what is the difference between monomeric and polymeric here. So but other 13th group elements form 13th group halides, trihalides. How many halogen atoms here we have? 3. Trihalides form polymeric halides. Forgetting stability. Let's see what is meaning of polymeric here. Halides. Polymeric means here. Should mention here dimer, form dimers. Dimer means two molecules, same dimer. Let's see. For example, AlCl3, aluminium trichloride, you know, it can form dimer. Dimer means two AlCl3 molecules are, this is one AlCl3. And this is another AlCl. Okay. So this is coordinate covalent bond. This aluminium donate 2 electrons to this chlorine donate electrons to aluminium. This chlorine donate electrons to this aluminium. These are the special bonds, coordinate covalent bonds. These are normal bonds. Okay. So all AlCl bonds are not same. Remember this Cl. This Cl donate 2 electrons to this. This Cl. These are special bonds. These two bonds are called as coordinate covalent bond. Coordinate covalent bond. Special type of bonds. But these four bonds, this one are another type of bond. Just only covalent bonds. This AlCl bond is only covalent bond only. Only covalent bond. These four are only covalent bond. These four, okay. But this bond and this bond act as coordinate covalent bond. So this is the bit. In AlCl3, all AlCl bonds are same? No. Why? It is coordinate covalent bond. These two all are not same type of bonds here. Remember this. Is it clear? This AlCl, this Al, this these two and this bond is same. But here this one is different bonds. Why? Because this fluorine donate 2 electrons to aluminium. But in this case, fluorine give 1 electron, aluminium give 1 electron. Equal sharing of electron. That is called covalent bond. Clear? This fluorine offer 1 electron, this aluminium offer 1 electron. Such type of bond is called as covalent bond only. But in this case, the 2 electrons donate from fluorine only. So that bond is called as coordinate covalent bond. Remember this phenomena here. So here how many AlCl3 molecules are combined like this? 2. So it is called dimer. That means remaining 13 group elements except boron, their halides can able to form like this. But boron halides BF3, BCl3 not give such kind of structures. Okay, that is the difference from other elements of 13th group and boron. So boron halides only monomer, they exist like this only, BF3, BCl3. But AlCl3 is also trihalides of 13th group element, but it can act as dimer. 2 molecules are combined, that is dimer. 3 trimer, tetramer, pentamer, hexamer, like that. Okay, remember this. And next one, hydrides, how boron differ from hydrides. Okay, so what about these hydrides of 13th group elements? Okay, so what are 13th group elements? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, am I right? Okay, these are the 13th group elements, clearly. So in that boron can, we have two types of hydrides here, BN HN plus 4, we discussed about this also, BN HN plus 6, already we completed this topic. Okay, so boron can form number of volatiles. Volatile means easily evaporated, like alcohol, petrol, ether, they easily evaporate at room temperature also. Easily converted as vapors, liquids converted as vapor is called as evaporation here. So volatile means the liquids which are easily evaporate as vapor is called as volatile. Okay. So now boron can form number of volatile hydrides which are electron deficient compounds. Electron deficient means they are not stable. Remember this. Example B2H6, diborane, am I right? Diborane is an electron deficient molecule, am I right? Already we discussed about this. So hydride is there. So it is boron hydride. Clear? Boron hydride. It is an electron deficient. It can vapor form, easily converted as vapor. So that is the meaning of this point. Okay? Boron easily form volatile hydrides. Aluminium gives AlH taken thrice, taken N. This aluminium hydride, this is polymeric hydride we call AlH taken thrice. Okay, so AlH taken thrice, taken N, these type of hydrates are called as polymeric hydride. And Ga2H6 is a, we call it is alane. These type of hydrates are called as alane. It is polymeric hydrate.
number of molecules such kind formed here. AlH3, AlH3 like this. Okay. Ga2H6 like B2H6. Ga2H6 like B2H6. It is dimeric hydride. Why? Because here how many gallions you have? 2 only. Gallium. We call it is digallane. Okay? Clear? And note here, thallium cannot form hydrides. Indium gives, so like aluminium, it is also polymeric hydride. These two are polymeric hydrides, this is dihydrides, and this one is thallium cannot form. So here boron can form volatile hydrides. Those are charged called as electron deficient compounds. So boron can very good from these remaining hydrides. Okay. So this is the anomalous behavior of boron. So abnormal behavior, different types of behavior from other elements in this. Okay. So note here the remaining all are, this is non-metal, the remaining are metals. Metal. This is non-metal or metalloid or semi-metal. Remember this. Okay. And next, oxides. Oxides. How boron differ in the case of oxides? So oxides means these elements with oxygen. This is B2O3 is acidic nature. Acidic nature like acetylactase. Next, Al2O3 and Ga2O3, these two are amphoteric oxides. Amphoteric means they can act as acid and also base. Okay. These three are bases. So here boron oxide act as acidic nature. It is different from other or not? Other. Clear? So this is the anomalous behavior of boron when comparing with remaining elements in 13th group. Okay? Boron does not attacked by boron does not attacked by non-oxidizing agent. Remember this, that examples are HCl, HBr and H3PO4. Already we discussed about this topic also. These are non-oxidizing agents. Okay, but that means boron not interact with this, but other elements add here dilute HCl also. Dilute H2SO4, not concentrated. Sulfuric acid, diluted means more water is added. Okay, but other elements of 13th group attacked by non-oxidizing agents like, let's see the example. Aluminum is other than boron, am I right? In the 13th group, aluminum when interact with HCl, it gives AlCl3 plus H2. Hydrogen gas is liberated. Okay, 6 hydrogen 6. How many chlorines here? 2, 3, 4, 6 chlorine, 6 chlorine, 6 hydrogen, 6 hydrogen, 1 aluminium. 2 aluminium, am I right? Clear? Once with the balance equation, 6 hydrogen, 3, 2, 6 hydrogen, clear? 2 aluminiums here. And how many chlorines here we have? 2, 3 jar, 6 chlorines and 6 chlorines. Clear? So this is the acid. This HCl is called as agent, non-oxidizing agent. Other elements except boron interact with other 30 group elements. Boron cannot interact with those. Okay, that is the difference between remaining elements and boron. Okay, but boron interact with HNO3, that is concentrated. Concentrated means so water content is very very less. That is original high concentrated HNO3. Okay, remember this. So when boron interact with the concentration CONC, concentration HNO3, it gives H3BO3. We can also write this BOH taken thrice. Both are correct. Both are correct. 3 hydrogens, 3 oxygen, 1 boron. Okay, and NO2. Balance this equation. Nitrogen dioxide 3, and here it is 3. 3 nitrogen here, 3 nitrogen, 6 oxygens, and here 6 plus 3, 9, 3, 3, 9, 3 hydrogen, 3 hydrogen, 1 boron. Okay, so name of this one, what is, can anybody? H3BO3 is called as boric acid or orthoboric acid. Both are correct. Okay, remember this. So when boron interact with the concentration HNO3, it gives orthoboric acid and nitrogen. It is weak acid, remember this. It is a weak acid. Weak acid, and we call it is monobasic acid. Monobasic acid. Remember this. This is the bit. Monobasic acid. Monobasic means it gives only 1H+ when dissolved in water. That means it gives only 1H+, only 1H+ when dissolved in water, then it is called monobasic. It is a weak acid. Okay, so it gives only one H plus when dissolved in water, that means it is monobasic acid. Suppose it gives 2H+, that is dibasic acid. It gives 3, it is tribasic acid. But in this case, this H3BO3 orthoboric acid or boric acid only gives 1H+, so we call it is clearly monobasic acid. It is a weak acid, less acidic in nature. Remember this. J-bit, very very important. So boron can interact with concentration HNO3, nitric acid. Okay, so what about the remaining elements, how they interact with concentration HNO3? Let's see, that is also important here. So other elements passive with concentration HNO3, especially aluminium and gallium. Okay, passive means suppose this is the aluminium metal rod. Aluminium, it is a metallic rod. Suppose we pour concentration HNO3 on the surface of this metal, initially this concentration HNO3 react with Al aluminium, it makes a thin film coating is formed. Thin film formed on the surface of metal rod. Okay, now this is aluminium, am I right? Aluminium or gallium. When concentration HNO3 placed on the surface of aluminium rod, initially the surface of the metal just interact with HNO3. Okay, and further this concentration HNO3 cannot interact with inside of the aluminium. So it is not completely react with entire aluminium, because aluminium makes a thin film or thin layer as film or layer on the surface of aluminium. This phenomena is called as passive. That means further aluminium cannot react completely with concentrated HNO3. Only surface aluminium will react with HNO3. This is the aluminium and we pour HNO3 here. What happened? So aluminium just make a thin layer on the surface of this aluminium rod. So that aluminium layer can prevent the further reaction of HNO3 with remaining aluminium. This phenomena is called as, we used here, passive. So due to this we prevent corrosion or rusting with atmosphere. Okay, already layer is formed on the surface of layer, then aluminium unable to interact with atmosphere, vapor or water, so which undergoes prevention, am I right? When aluminium rod interact with water, it may undergoes corrosion, am I right? But due to this thin film on the surface of aluminium, it unable to interact with water. Okay, that means corrosion, rusting of iron, you know, that phenomena is called as corrosion. Okay, due to this thin film, we prevent the corrosion here. Remember this, okay, corrosion. So these are the difference, but boron interact with HNO3, it gives orthoboric acid, but in this case, the remaining elements like aluminium, gallium, unable to interact with concentration, even they interact with concentration HNO3, they form a thin film on the surface of metal rod, okay, which further, it prevents the further reaction with aluminium and concentration HNO3. Okay, that is the difference between remaining elements and boron. So this is the abnormal behavior of boron also. And see next property, boron shows allotropy. Allotropy means same element in different physical state. Okay. So boron shows crystalline allotropes and amorphous allotropes. Amorphous means like powder, crystalline means like NaCl, sodium chloride, like salt. Remember this. Okay, so allotropy means, for example, for your easy understanding, allotropy means, let us take diamond, another one is graphite. You know pencil very well, diamond is very precious and it is very strong, am I right? Very costly and very precious. Graphite is, where we use graphite? In pencil. It is very smooth, okay, very smooth, and that means it is very weak. Okay, very weak and very smooth and very less cost, am I right? But in this diamond, it consists carbon, and graphite it is consists also carbon. So your carbon exists in two different forms, am I right? Two different forms. One is diamond, another one is graphite. The same element exists in two different forms. That phenomena is called as allotropy. Okay, so in the same manner here, boron is also exists allotropic in nature. So like crystalline means they are like NaCl, sodium chloride, like salt, but amorphous means like powder. These type of compounds are exist with borons, okay? So that phenomena is called as allotropy, okay? And the next one is boron forms boron forms that means other elements of other elements of 13th group forms alloys means here 2 or more metals combines. Okay, suppose copper and aluminium. Okay, this is one of the alloy. So two metals, aluminium is 13th group. Okay, so two or more metals are combined together and mixed it, that is called alloy. Okay, so by preparation of alloys we can prevent corrosion or rusting. Steel also example for alloy. Steel also example for alloys. Okay, so other elements of 13th group elements can able to form alloys. Alloys means two or more metals combined together to form a one special metal, mixed metal, that is called alloy. Okay, clear? So now aluminium 13th group can able to form a alloy with copper. Okay, you know steel very well. What is the difference between steel and iron? Iron easily undergoes rusting when keep it outside, but steel doesn't undergo rusting easily. Am I right? That is the difference. Alloys means these are making by two or more metals by the combination. Okay, is it clear, student? So due to small size of boron, small atomic radius of and high energy of boron, it has some special properties when comparing with the remaining elements of 13th group elements. Okay, students. Again, we will meet on tomorrow. Write the notes properly, very neatly. If you have any doubt, ask me. I will explain. Okay. And the next topic is tomorrow topic. Some similarities between boron and aluminium. Okay, boron and aluminium. What are the similarities and what are the differences between boron and aluminium? That is the topic. After that, we go for completely boron and the complete study of aluminium again. Okay, so very very important topic. There are some important compounds are there with respect to boron and aluminium. We'll discuss about that already. One important compound we discussed about boron, that is diborane B2A6. Already wrote the exam in that. Okay, we got very good marks. One of the student got 92 out of 100 marks also. Okay, very good. Keep it up. More practice the bits. So what I gave. Okay, thank you very much. Have a nice day.